Australian bookies Sportsbet has today refunded punters more than $400,000 in bets on the Black Caps after this morning's knife-edge World Cup loss against England. Both teams scored 241 after 50 overs, and an extra super over also ended in a tie with both teams scoring 15. But England took the trophy because they scored more boundaries during the game. Sportsbet labelled that decision as an absolute disgrace, saying it couldn't take money off 11,000 punters when the Black Caps didn't technically lose. Fans at Lords were also left confused and bewildered after this morning's result. As sports reporters Ravinder, Hunia and Simon Hampton report, many had never heard of a super over, and supporters on both sides were left shaking their heads.
It was a Cricket World Cup finale no one could have predicted.
7 weeks of cricket, 48 games, one ball, here's Bolt. They're going to push. Are we in for a super over? They've got to go quick, they've got to go quick.
New Zealand and England battling it out in a super over to see who would become World Cup champions for the very first time.
This is the moment, it's Archer to Guptill. 2 to win. Guptill's going to push for two, they've got to go. Throw's got to go to the keeper's end. He's got it, England have won the World Cup.
But what is a super over? Not many people I spoke to after the match knew the answer either.
It was an unbelievable game and can't quite believe how we got into that super over at the end, really. The New Zealand were just unbelievably unlucky, really. I thought you played amazingly, and for the second half of that whole game I thought you were going to win. So commiserations, but you know, I think a draw would have been a fair result, really. But incredible game and incredible atmosphere for Lords. That's kind of unbelievable, really.
There was a lot of shuffling of paper where I was sitting to try and work it out. But, you know, I've seen a few of them in 2020. And, you know, I'm not entirely sure it's the best way to solve a tied game. It's a bit like a penalty shootout in football. But you have to have a way to decide it, I guess. But, it was always going to be tough. And, you know, in the end, the super over was tied as well as the game was tied. That probably shows you it was just one of the most incredible games of cricket you'll ever see.
From a tie in score to sudden death, it was England who became victors at home for the very first time, and what it meant to its home fans was evident.
We started batting and we realised that actually 240 was a really good score. They went super over. I thought when you guys hit your six, wow, I thought it was over. Archer, you know, West Indian or not, like he had the right shirt on today.
Leaving Black Caps fans deflated, confused and wondering how a grand final could end like this.
Unbelievable. It's hard to explain, you know. Your legs are wobbling, your heart's racing. You know, it was an impossible win that they just pulled off and got ripped out right out from under us. Stokes, where it hit them and went to the boundary, we'd won it until then. And then super over and it's a draw and they win on most boundaries. It's just an unbelievable game. It's just ridiculous.
Did you think that a super over would eventuate, and did you know anything about a super over?
Yeah, I did know super over would go on a draw, but you know, it's just phenomenal how it ended that way, you know. Everything went their way today.
Extremely proud. I mean, we weren't really given a chance before the tournament, and then to get like this close, like to tie the game effectively and lose, pretty gutting.
Magnificent game, and one in a lifetime. There'll be no game like that again. No, two draws in one day.
Every Kiwi we've spoken to are calling it two draws, while the English are calling it a win. Do you think that it's a deserved win by the English?
It could have gone either way, and it was just so close. It was just great to be at the ground to see such a spectacle with fine margins. Just a close, you know, gut-wrenching, really.
Not so confusing for former White Ferns captain Susie Bates, though. She is well-versed in the super over rule from her experience in T20 cricket, but says it doesn't soften the blow of a national loss.
I actually didn't know those were the rules. I thought that maybe the team who had finished top in the table would have won, but when I heard it was a super over, I sort of thought that was, I guess, at least a fair way to try and get a result, but they're never fun. I have played in a couple through 2020, and look, it's just one of those things. You get a batter that can tee off, and it's just critical moments can go one way or the other, and unfortunately, like I said, England we got those, I guess, good results and managed to win at home, which is, you know, great for them and great for the crowd, but the New Zealand supporters, I think, will not forget that one in a while.
Bates only just made her way to the UK once she realised the Black Caps' fate and says a game of this magnitude will only bring one of two things, great celebration or great disappointment.
What a game, probably the best World Cup final ever in history. And look, it's sad that there has to be a team on the losing side, and I thought New Zealand were brilliant in the field and there were just some critical moments at the end that didn't go our way, and unfortunately we were on the other side of that final. But yeah, still a little bit emotional about it all. I was with lots of the Kiwi families and it was pretty tense up there.
So talk to us a little bit more about that, where you were sitting and what exactly you saw post-match.
Yeah, we were with a few of the New Zealand cricket staff and some of the families. Trent Bolt's brother Jono was leading the charge with the chanting, and there was a really good atmosphere, and Gary Stead's parents. So look, everyone was, I think, with five overs to go, pretty confident. We'd done a really good job, but you know, with cricket, anything can happen. And yeah, I just, no one could have picked any of that. I think the four off Ben Stokes' bat was really unfortunate, but to still get a tie and tie the game twice, it's not really fair. There's a winner, but that's cricket.
And Minister of Sport Grant Robertson says the loss doesn't take away the impact of what making today's final will have on cricket in New Zealand.
This will do wonders for people's interest in cricket. The whole country stopped for it, didn't it? And yeah, look, you know, when we've got some a big summer of cricket coming up. We've got the Boxing Day Test, and which is just going to be incredible. There's some really amazing opportunities there. We've got the Women's Cricket World Cup in 2021. Cricket's a game for all New Zealanders. People love it, and this has just been another occasion for us to celebrate that just be really proud.
In England, though, a World Cup trophy sparks a new generation of future hopefuls.
It was amazing.
Do you play cricket yourself?
Yeah.
And is this going to be you one day at a World Cup?
Maybe. I don't know yet.
How did you feel when you saw the team holding up the trophy?
I was just overwhelmed. It was such, like it was the first time we've won it, and to be there to watch it was amazing.
So there you have it. England are the 2019 Cricket World Cup champions. New Zealand can hold their heads up high, though, knowing they were a part of one of the greatest cricket games of all time. Mo te hōtaka o te ahi pō nei, ko Ravinder Hunia tēnei.